Hey, horse people, knocking out some videos while I got my cold stuck in the house. All right, so someone sent me this one. I mean, I'll tell you, I just don't understand jumpers. I just don't get it. It hurts the horse. It's not good. It doesn't appear to be fun to me. I realize I don't do it, but just running a horse in circles and jumping over something, I just don't get the drive to it. Other than the ribbons and to tell everybody how great you are, because you can force a horse to jump and hurt his feet. And to me, this person is a typical jumper. Every jumper I've ever seen, either on videos or in person, has the same attitude as this person. And I know all the jumpers will be here hating on me. Well, I jump and I don't do that. And you shouldn't judge everybody. And you make general. Okay, I'm just telling you. I've got a lot of time around horses and a lot of time on this earth. I'm older, probably twice as old as most people that watch me, and I'm telling you, this is the attitude of most all jumpers. They don't do it in public, and they don't do it at the show, but this is what happens when they're out in the arena by themselves and they think nobody's watching. Let's see this good training method by this expert jumper. Wow, that's really good. There'll be some idiot jumper saying, "Well, you have to show the horse who's boss, and the horse shouldn't resist, and you know the horse should learn that it needs to go." The horse doesn't like to jump, people. I mean, you could find videos all day, every day, of horses not wanting to jump. They don't like to jump. I don't care how much you try to convince yourself because you want to justify your abuse. Horses don't like jumping. They especially don't like jumping high, long, running in circles, and jumping 20, 30, 40 times a day, every day, mindless pain, pounding on their feet, all their weight landing on their front feet 20, 30, 40 times a day. It's just not good for the horse. And you can get mad at me and say I hate jumpers and take it all personally and want to make a hate site or whatever, but I'm telling you. Look around. I've never been to a jumper show. I've never been to a place where people were practicing jumping that a horse didn't try to get around or jump and not want to jump. Never. I've never seen a horse. And some idiot's going to put some video in here where some horse gets loose and jumps all the jumps by himself. See, this horse likes. The horse jumps it all by himself because he knows he's going to do it anyway. He's been conditioned and he just does it. He doesn't care. Some horses give up easier. Some horses just accept their fate and say, screw it. There is not a horse out there that likes to jump. I don't care how many people I mean, it just kills me. Okay, so let's try to look at this guy's great horse stopping, out of position, goes head over heels. Watch him hang onto the reins and rip the horse's face off with the reins. Hanging on the reins, the horse is getting yanked and pulled. This person right here, I can't tell if it's guy or girl, will be telling everybody, I have soft hands. Bits don't hurt. And then I'll have other jumpers coming here saying, well, when I jump, I was always told when a horse does this, don't hold on to the reins. It's a clinch response. I talk about it on my gun channel when I'm talking about we're training cops. You cannot stop letting go of the reins when you're going over the edge. It's called a clench or squeeze response. Your hands tighten up. You're going to hang on the reins and you're going to rip the horse's mouth and you're going to yank that metal bit into his teeth and you're probably going to chip a tooth and you're going to cut blood circulation off his gums and you're going to mash his tongue and you're going to rip the side of his cheek out. Anybody who wants to tell me this person has soft hands and bits don't hurt horses, it just kills me. But you know what? Still not letting go. Hanging on. Horse is like, dude, it hurts. What is the horse learning? Horse is learning when I stop here and a stupid human falls off, he's going to hurt me and I'm going to get more pain. So next time I want to jump, I don't want to jump even more because I know what happens when I come up to these jumps. It never turns out well. I can jump it and then it hurts my feet and I have tendons and I have pains. So when I don't try to jump it hurts my legs because I don't want to jump it. And then when I stop to jump it, the guy rips my face off and I wonder why my horse doesn't like jumping. Rick, my horse loves jumping. I talked about learned helplessness before. Horse just figures out no matter what I do, I'm going to hurt. So it really doesn't matter what I do. And then, in all the wisdom of the great jumper who wears a helmet because they're safe, Rick, you gotta wear a helmet because that makes you safe and smart because you're protecting your brain. You're protecting your damn brain that you don't use most of the time any damn way. You especially don't use it when you're on horses. So now I'll just chase the horse and throw the jump at it. That's perfect. Because that's going to help the horse like jumping, not be fearful of jumping, and learn to respect my space and show him who's boss. And I'll show this horse. If I want to make you jump and cause pain on your legs and you try and stop me, I'm going to rip your face off with a bit and then I'm going to throw a jump on you. Okay. Come here with your ignorant comments about how I got this all wrong and how I'm just picking on this great jumper person for no reason. Well, Lynette there.